Ripple keeps making gains, as BitBoy and many others notice. But will this be enough to win the case? And who are the newest influential supporters of Ripple? Stay tuned till the end of the video to find out. But first, we are giving away $500 at the end of the month to one random subscriber to start on their XRP journey. All you need to do is to like the video, subscribe and comment your thoughts on XRP in the comment section.
Hey guys, have you ever heard about Stablepool? If you own XRP and are interested in making constant money on exchanges like 1inch, Uniswap and co., then this website is perfect for you. After having to sign up to the site with your email, you can simply go to Top Up and select the currency and the amount of it that you want to deposit on the site. Now go to Open DeFi Staking or add liquidity in Liquidity Pool. The site shows you how much of that amount you'll earn as interest within 12 hours, usually around 0.1 to 0.2%. Within 1 year, you'll have made 2x without any risk, which helped the site receive more than $80 million within the first week. And the best part, if you sign up until October 31st TH, you'll receive $50 in a random cryptocurrency for free.
Welcome back, XRP Army. The BitBoy cryptocurrency, in addition to indicating that Ripple is moving closer to resolving its lawsuit against the Securities and Exchange Commission, has also demonstrated that Ripple is gaining popularity. The market was under the impression that the case would be decided in favor of the regulator at the outset, but experience has proven that this assumption was false. In the end, Ripple appears to have given the Securities and Exchange Commission, SEC, a run for its money. But it is the members of the XRP community who appear to have come out on top, a factor that the SEC almost certainly overlooked when bringing what some have referred to as a last-minute lawsuit against the cryptocurrency. Following the case, Brian Armstrong, the CEO of Bitcoin exchange Coinbase, has claimed on Twitter that appears to be going better than expected. As well as this, he addressed the unexpected consequences that the SEC is facing as a result of the pressure exerted by those who have been disadvantaged by the Ripple action, notably the holders of XRP. Armstrong described himself in the following way: "The Ripple case seems to be going better than expected. Meanwhile, the SEC is realizing that attacking crypto is politically unpopular because it harms consumers." By the way, what do you think about this statement? Let us know in the comment section down below. However, even though the plaintiff was neither a Wall Street giant nor a significant financial institution, the lawsuit had a direct impact on the financial situation of the XRP community since the token was removed from a number of cryptocurrency exchanges as a result of the case. The cryptocurrency is still being delisted by multiple exchanges because of concerns about possible sanctions from the United States Securities and Exchange Commission, according to legal expert John Deaton. Deaton has been representing XRP holders and their interests in the Ripple vs. SEC case since it was first filed in 2014. Deaton has been a cornerstone in the litigation since it was first filed in 2014. Deaton has also been reporting on the discrepancies of the regulator's statements over the duration of the probe. Clayton's decision to file a legal complaint against Ripple was one of the most significant decisions he took during his tenure as CEO, and it also one of the most difficult. A number of individuals had hoped that the current SEC chair, Gary Gensler, would open the door to conversation and a rapid resolution of the situation, but this has not yet transpired. When the market crashed, Clayton abandoned Ripple and XRP investors and went to work for a private sector business. He is now serving as an advisor to One River Digital Asset Management on its Academic and Regulatory Advisory Council, which is comprised of academics and regulators. He formerly served as chair of the Securities and Exchange Commission. While this has been going on, the XRP community has continued to organize and push back against the SEC in a case that, depending on the outcome, may have a significant impact on the whole cryptocurrency industry. The scenario appears to be understood by people like Armstrong, who are cognizant of the potential dangers it poses to cryptocurrency-based enterprises. The current chair of the Securities and Exchange Commission has advocated for more authority to monitor the Bitcoin business. Even if Ripple prevails in the case or is successful in negotiating with the government, it is likely that other companies, cryptocurrency projects, and their respective communities may find themselves in a similar position. A legal precedent in favor of the crypto sector may be formed in the alternative scenario, but the regulator would then have the legal ability to clamp down on any asset that they deem to be a security, rather than creating a legal precedent in favor of the crypto sector. The list, according to recent remarks made by Gensler on the matter, particularly in reference to DeFi, may be a long one. Comment, XRP Army, if you believe Ripple will win the case. Ripple's fan base is expanding, and it includes a rising number of billionaires who are speaking out in support of the cryptocurrency, as well as attorneys, former SEC officials, and members of the online community, among others. A billionaire investor, Mike Novogratz, argues that a new phenomenon of community resilience has led the price of XRP to more than quadruple, in spite of an ongoing litigation by the United States Securities and Exchange Commission. As the founder and CEO of Galaxy Digital, Novogratz brings his extensive experience in the hedge fund industry to bear on the company's expansion into the digital asset, cryptocurrency, and blockchain technology industries. Galaxy Digital's headquarters are in San Francisco, California, and it was founded in 2004. The founder of Galaxy Digital, Michael Novogratz, believes that the price of XRP has continued to grow despite increased scrutiny from the Securities and Exchange Commission. Galaxy Digital was founded in 2018. In a recent tweet, Novogratz stated that the price of the XRP cryptocurrency token has nearly doubled as a result of the SEC's actions against the cryptocurrency token in question. In his statement, Novogratz claimed it was a credit to the cryptoasset community's capacity to be damn resilient, as he put it. Novogratz continued his comparison of XRP's community support to that of GameStop Corporation by stating that the latter company's stock value increased by a large amount as a consequence of the activity on online trading forums, notably the well-known subreddit r, Wall Street Bets. In the opinion of Novogratz, the recognition of the importance of communal identity is a relatively new phenomenon. Federal Judge Annalisa Torres denied XRP holders' request to intervene in the Securities and Exchange Commission's lawsuit against blockchain firm Ripple on the grounds that it would unduly delay the action, demonstrating the community's power in the process. Do you agree that XRP's price gains show how great the community is? If yes, then make sure to like this video. Although the situation appears to be bleak, there is one bright spot. After this, the movers will be able to proceed as amici curiae, which means that they will be able to file the following papers in the case. This means that movants will be permitted to intervene as amici curiae in this matter on their own behalf in accordance with the provisions of applicable law. The court will thus grant the opportunity to movants in order to help it by presenting the court with briefings on major legal issues relevant to the case that have been approved in advance by the court. It should be noted that in this lawsuit, XRP holders are not authorized to testify or summon witnesses on their behalf. In order to prevent being singled out for prejudice, their participation is limited to legal issues alone. According to You Today, the request was first denied without prejudice when a technology malfunction occurred in mid-March. According to attorney John Deaton of the Deaton Law Firm, who spearheaded the effort to incorporate members of the XRP community in the case, Ripple's legal struggle with the Securities and Exchange Commission, SEC, has reportedly caused injury to both people and businesses. The SEC stated that XRP investors were forcing the agency to take legal action against them by reiterating the talking points of Ripple's argument, and that this was a violation of federal securities laws. Anyways, these news shows, as BitBoy also brilliantly examined, how strong the XRP community really is and that it may be the main winner or Ripple in this case. What do you think about Ripple's gains in the SEC case? Do you think we'll see Ripple's win sue? Let us know in the comment section. If you want to continue to know about XRP, we have got two videos waiting for you on the end screen to check out. Make sure to subscribe and give us a thumbs up. Thank you so much for watching. See you in the next video. Kindly note that prices of cryptocurrencies frequently change, so by the time you watch this video, it might have changed to a whole new value. The information provided in this video does not constitute investment advice, financial advice, trading advice, or any other sort of advice, and you should not treat any of the content as such. The content in this video is for educational purposes only and hence should not be considered financial advice. Do conduct your due diligence and consult your financial advisor before making any investment decisions.